Hey everyone, in today's video I wanted to show you how we can use JavaScript to program your Flipboard macro pad. In this video, we'll look at using the Flipboard as a USB keyboard, and we'll also look at using it as an infrared remote and to control sub-gigahertz devices. I think most people will find reading and editing JavaScript much easier than reading the native applications. Let's get started. The first example we'll look at is infrared. The green button toggles the power. The red button increases the volume of the TV. The yellow button decreases the volume of the TV. And if you hold the blue button, then the red button is for increasing the channel and the yellow button is for decreasing the channel. And the green button again will cycle the power. The buttons from left to right are 1, 2, 4, and 8. This allows us to check for a single button press or a multi-button press using the bitwise OR operator. When button number 4 is pressed, we add a new line and then print the text volume down. Then we use infrared send protocol using Samsung 32 address 7 command 0B. This causes the TV volume to decrease. When buttons 4 and 8 are both pressed, we print a new line and the text channel down, and our infrared signal is command 0x10 instead. The easiest way to see what parameters to use is to use the infrared app, go to learn new remote, and then press the button on your remote control. Note that your script could send multiple commands like power on TV input and type in a channel number. This next example uses the Flipboard to send sub-gigahertz signals to control a light. If button 1 is pressed, we start the speaker at 540 Hz at volume 100%. We then use sub-gigahertz transmit file to send a sub-gigahertz file. And once that file's been transmitted, we stop the speaker. And again, your script could send multiple sub-gigahertz files or combine it with infrared signals as well. For this last example, we'll look at how we use the Flipboard script to do bad USB. And in this case, we're going to use a widget. And that widget allows us to show images and text. So I'm showing a splash screen. Then we're picking our keyboard layout. I have the ENUK layout. And now you can see the widgets with our different icons. When we press a button, we're changing that. And now it's doing Control-Alt-Delete and pulling up the task manager. We called init bad USB with prompt. So we had that prompt. You could instead specify the path to a keyboard layout if you didn't want to prompt the user. When button 1 is pressed, we do a Control-Alt-Delete. We wait a second for the screen to appear. We press the down button twice, so we're hovering over the sign out option. We delay 2 seconds, and then we press down and enter to bring up the task manager. Check out my wiki and my other bad USB videos for more information on programming bad USB. I recommend the Momentum dev branch, so you're going to say connect, and then instead of release, choose Dev in the dropdown, and then click the Flash button. Most of the unofficial firmwares have a dev branch that contains the GPIO, sub-gigahertz, text box, and widget that we used in our scripts. If you're on your stable or release branch, it's possible that those features are not yet in your firmware. The README explains the process if you want to go ahead and build your own FAL files for release firmware, so you don't have to switch to dev. It just makes the process a little bit simpler. Over on Flipper Zero Tutorials, click on Code and then Download Zip. Then right-click on the zip file and choose Extract All. Open the tutorials and then go to JavaScript and then go to Flipboard. Then in QFlipper, open the file browser, go to SD card, apps, scripts, then go ahead and right click and choose new folder, scroll down, and then change your folder name to Flipboard, all lowercase. Scroll back up open the Flipboard folder, and then in Windows, open the Scripts folder, select all the files, and drag them into QFlipper. Navigate back up to SD card, and this time go to apps underscore data, and then JS underscore app, and then plugins. And then over here, go to FAL, and then go to our dev branch, and then check for each file. Make sure that it's not already in your firmware. If you have it in your firmware, don't copy this over because your firmware is probably more recent than the video. Now that we've updated the Flipper application library and the scripts, we're ready to go in to apps, scripts, Flipboard, and you should see that a_runner.js. And then it'll ask you for the FBJS that you want to run, and then your script will start running. Let's take a quick look at that runner script. You can see we prompt the user to pick an fb.js file, and then we load that file with an alias of fn. We load colorapi.js with an alias of color, and then we set the color of our four buttons. We call the script's init method, passing it the loader, and then every time buttons are pressed or released, we update the LEDs, and we call the script's buttonPressed method. We already looked at how the infrared does the primary action for the different buttons, but let's take a look at the init function. We set flipboardButton.repeat to true, and this means if a button's held down, we'll get the value plus ORed with button 16 for repeat. Since this JavaScript's using infrared, we do the require of infrared. In the other files, we do init sub gigahertz or init bad USB. At the bottom of the file, we have that button pressed method. And if button 1, which is power, and 16, which is repeat, is being held down, we just return because we don't want to keep toggling the power on and off. Next, we use and tilde 16 to remove that repeat flag. And if the button is 0, that means all the keys were just released, so we just return. Button 8 is the channel button, but they haven't picked up or down yet, so we just return. Next, we play a tone for 100 milliseconds, and then we call that primary action method up at the top of our file. Now you know how to edit fb.js files to unlock the potential of your Flipboard using JavaScript. My Flipper Discord server is the best way to reach out with questions. Please like this video and subscribe to the channel. Also, let me know what additional JavaScript features you would like with the Flipboard.